Have you ever thought of slugs as beautiful? Marine biologist Marta Pola does, especially the ones called nudibranchs. She saw her first one on a college field trip to the south coast of Spain.
They brought back from the sea a lot of different animals for the student to look at the surface and under the microscopes. There was when I saw my first sea slug moving under a microscope, and I just fell in love for them. They were great, it was moving around, very, very bright color, and I didn't know what was it, but I did know that I wanted to study them, and if possible, to study them for a living.
Nudibranchs, or sea slugs, are related to snails. Like them, they have a mouth part called a radula. Its rough surface is studded with tiny teeth for scraping off bits of food. Nudibranchs eat sponges, jellies, crustaceans, and even other nudibranchs. But without a shell for protection, how do nudibranchs avoid becoming a meal themselves? The ones that eat jellyfish get something more than just food from their prey.
The ones that feed on cnidarians, like jellies, jellies have stinging cells for defending themselves. But what nudibranchs do is they are capable to acquire the stinging cells, which are called nematocysts, and they transport these nematocysts to a tiny sac that they have on the tip of the cerata.
Predators that touch the cerata get a jolt when the stinging cells inside are released. And a nudibranch's brilliant colors and patterns aren't just pretty to look at.
Those colors actually have a really really important mission, which is to advertise the predator that they are toxic. They are distasteful and they have poison.
But Marta says that some nudibranchs can be a challenge to find.
Not all nudibranchs have this spectacular coloration, but some of them actually are really difficult to find because they have colors that camouflage the substrate in which they are found. And it's almost impossible to find. We can spend almost a 60 minutes dive just trying to find nudibranchs under a couple of rocks.
With so many places to hide, even nudibranchs with flashy colors are not always easy to see. Each time Marta goes to the Philippine Islands for her research, she isn't surprised to discover more new species.
Actually, we went back to the Philippines and we found 97 species that were not known from the Philippines. Of these 97 species, at least 60 species were completely known to science.
Because so much is unknown about their diversity and their importance in coral reef ecosystems, for Marta, the beauty of nudibranchs is more than just skin deep.
Nudibranchs are interesting to study not only because they are gorgeous and they are very diverse and they are very good indicators of healthy environments.
They may also contain chemical compounds that could be useful in making pharmaceuticals.
Maybe the cure against the cancer is in one of these guys and is sitting there waiting to be discovered.